365, iHeartRadio.com. Listen via Sirius Channel 432. Watch and listen at WGSJBC.com.
Maestro, if you please.
The Maya Akai Show. Radio viewer never looked so good.
Second win. I love Billy Joel.
Second win, baby.
I love Billy Joel.
Baby, I've had 4 second wins.
I might be on 3 or 4 myself there. You know, you hit that stride after the 4-0 and it's like, ooh, man.
Gotta regroup.
The Maya Kai Show with Nikki Braden.
Hey,
you're listening to us on Smooth 90.5 FM HD Radio, the new home. The Maya Kai Show. And there's so many ways to listen. You can tune in via Sirius XM, channel 432. We're on Live 365. We're on iHeartRadio.com. And if you want to watch and listen, because we do that via live stream, just go to the station website, www.wjbcradio.com. And you can watch and listen, or even click and listen too. It'll take you right to the Live 365 link. So there's so many ways to get involved in actually experiencing the show. You can call in too. Mark Chafee is sending me some serious messages on Facebook.
Mark,
I'm trying to multitask, but my second win's not there yet today. So if you want to call in to talk about this, 708-223-0030. Or do you have something to say? I'm sure people are going to staunchly disagree with me on some things, and it's okay. We can agree to disagree because our perspectives are not always going to be on the same page. But I think the one thing that we can agree about, Nikki, is that there's something seriously wrong in this country. People are broken.
Yes.
And they're fixable, but we have to want to do that collectively.
We do. We have to cherry pick these people. I'm just trying to figure out, I like identifying problems. I also like throwing out a solution, and I just really don't know how you can find, because the broken that this young man that we're talking about from South Carolina, the broken part of him with, you know, men raping white women and that kind of thing, I don't know where that mindset came from. And
something,
I don't know,
there's something behind that.
There's something
we don't know what it is yet, but there's
know
something
what that
behind
is,
that.
But can you fix that? Because that's not even true.
It depends. We have to know more about what it is, especially from a psychological standpoint. we have to know more about what it is before we can figure out we can fix it. Because right. I'll be honest, sometimes I see patients that I don't know that they're fixable. I've felt that way at times.
Like, see, I'm like, there's something broke that you can't. That can't.
Sometimes, sometimes Gorilla Tape and super glue does not work.
It does not work.
But before we get into the second half of Food for Thought, which is what I feel is the inquisition of taking over Father's Day. Happy Father's Day, Mom. Uh-huh. I want to kind of plug in Hooray for Humans.
Okay, because let's do that.
Let's give a upside to at least. Every now and then when you're confronted with something, you can make a good choice. So tell us about Sydney.
Oh, my baby. Okay, here's the deal. I mean, she's a teenager. She's a typical teenager. I would say an average student, A, B. She's had a sprinkle of C's here and there. But overall, she's a typical high school student. She plays sports. She had a job. But, you know, that age of 16 to 17, there's some rebellion and this that kind of thing. So she was going to the Blackhawks parade, mm-hmm. and she asked if she could spend a night over her friend's house, and then they were going to get up and they were going to all take the train down, and I'm like, sure, and you know, she has her own car, so you know, I was like, fine. And then she left, and then like an hour later she came back with all her stuff, and I was like, what are you doing here? And she's like, oh, they're trying to conspire to buy liquor to drink on the train, and I'm not going now, I don't want any part of that. And I looked at her and I was all like, oh my gosh. She was, and I mean, she was just like, nah, I'm not gonna even go. And it was just that moment when you, you know, when you're a parent and you always worry about your teenager and are they making the right decisions? Because she could have gone and not drank. She True. Just decided not to go at all. So when you realize that, you know, I got through somewhere, because you never know, because they always have an attitude.
Right, the breakthrough, the breakthrough.
It's that breakthrough. So I was very, 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 very proud of her. And so, yeah, sometimes I just want you, parents out there, just keep grilling it. Keep grilling it. They'll get it. And so it's that moment. I'm like, shit.
And then you said you actually, and here's another good hooray for humans. You know, a few couples that are celebrating their anniversaries, right?
Yeah,
it's good people staying married, because nowadays it seems like you don't hear that, and all the adversities and the brick walls, you need a second wind sometimes to stay married.
Yes,
you know, a couple people.
I've had three or four
anniversaries.
Yes, three or four. Yeah, a friend of mine, Dakiti Mobley, she's been married, I think this is her 10th year. We have a Christine Turton, she's been married for 9 years.
Fantastic.
9 years, and it goes by so fast. I was at her wedding, I was like, has it been 9? But you know what, it has, because I'm coming up on 10. Can you believe that?
Somebody stuck with you for 10 years.
10 years. Hello.
Hey now.
Hello.
There is hope. Yes. There is hope, because Ziggy Brady is hitting on 10.
Either that or I am not that bad. I'm not as bad as everybody thinks.
That might be true. That actually might be true. Yep. All right. So we figured we would just plug Hooray Humans in there, because sometimes everything is so doom and gloom. It's good to know that teenagers can be forward thinking, and hey, they do listen.
They do listen.
It does get through. And that was a big choice, because she could have just not maybe drank, but just went along with it, but decided to send a message to her peers and walk away.
And walk away.
And I think that is that's worth acknowledging and celebrating. Yes. So parents out there, when you think your kids probably aren't listening.
They are.
They are. Especially if you've done a stellar job.
Yes.
It's just, you know how it is when you were a kid. You didn't want to acknowledge that your parents were right.
Did not.
Let's be real about this. You're over the hump, we know. Okay.
You're like, okay. They were right. You always say it like that. Okay. They were right.
Right. Exactly. All right. Let's get back to food for thought. Yes. So I feel like there is an inquisition being set to take over Father's Day. We saw that Mahogany Greeting Cards has a Happy Father's Day Mom card, which I was staunchly against. Mm. And if that wasn't enough, Angel Soft, which is a toilet paper, which I don't know if there's something oxymoronic about that a toilet paper.
I get it. Yeah, I get it.
Has created this ad, Happy Father's Day Mom, and they have all these different people in this ad talking about their mom and wishing her a Happy Father's Day. And to me, actually, a lot of people fought back and gave a lot of negative feedback, like, hey, this is Father's Day.
I'm getting ready to do it.
What are you doing?
I want you
to take a listen to the ad and tell me what you think about it. This is Happy Father's Day Mom. It was an Angel Soft ad.
My father passed away when I was 3. There was 4 of us kids within 5 years. So my mom had to raise 4 kids by herself.
My mom was a single mother, so she raised both of us completely by herself. Which is... I'm sorry.
I don't know how she raised 3 boys on her own with such grace.
I've definitely seen her try to juggle both mom, dad, and you know everything else that she had to be for herself. She did all of it, and she did it all as though she was 2 people.
But she was tough, huh?
She was not a joke.
Say our car broke down. Oh, well, that's the alternator.
She was like, when you punch, she's like, you put your knuckle out and you just go for it. I mean, I don't even know if that's a thing.
Even like opposite of her toughness, it was something very fragile, you know?
Anything that needs help, a person, a thing, an animal, she will find it and she will nurse it back to health. That's my mom.
Always very affectionate, very hugging and kissing and all of that. It was always nothing but love.
She really is like the most amazing mother, but she was really an incredible father. Like truly incredible.
All right, that was an ad by Angel Soft Toilet Paper that took a lot of different people accounting for their experiences growing up with a single mom, and they titled it Happy Father's Day, Mom. This is something that has been going on for quite some time, and I'm going to be honest. I really have an issue with it, and I came from a single-parent home.
I have a problem.
And I was raised by my mom.
I have a problem with this.
Because here's my thing. On Mother's Day, we don't try to discredit mothers, because there's plenty of fathers that are raising children on their own. Every mother isn't stellar, by the way.
Right.
This is about celebrating dad.
Right.
Now, if dad happens to not be in your life, I understand.
Right.
But I don't think you have a right to take a day like this and to try to change it into something that it's not.
It wasn't meant for you. And we had our day. So everything that your mother did, she still did that for you, and you get to celebrate it on Mother's Day. You don't get an extra award because somebody else wasn't there. That doesn't make you a father. It just makes you a single parent, and your day was Mother's Day.
And you had to do maybe a bit more to fill the role and to get things done.
Yes.
But let me just say this. My mom did an exceptional job. Sure. She was a fantastic parent. But at no point of time did I ever liken the fact that she was my dad because he wasn't there.
Exactly.
And in fact, I'll say, even though I think she did a stellar job, I clearly know as I become an adult, there were things in my life that are clearly different about me because I didn't have a father. Mm-hmm. And those were voids that she couldn't fill because those were only things that a male figure could have given to me. Mm-hmm. Each parent gives a unique experience to their child.
They do.
What a father gives to his son, what a father gives to his daughter,
and what a mother gives to her son.
It's just different experiences and it prepares you for the world. Mm-hmm. And I dislike this because I feel once again, it's taking a stab at the role of a father in the home. Now, here's a solution to this. Have single parent day.
If you would like, if you need 2 days, then
have single parent days.
But you don't need 2 days. It's a Mother's Day and it's a Father's Day. But that covers the gamut.
I agree. But if for some reason there's a need to feel like single parenting and
why are you being greedy?
But unfortunately, in our society, once again, we talk about things that are broken. Don't take that personally, single parents, because I came from a single parent home. But I'm gonna tell you something. If I would have had the option to have two parents, I would have loved to. Uh-huh. And I collectively made a decision to not have children when I realized I was going to be a single parent, mm-hmm, before I got divorced. Mm-hmm. That was a very, trust me, my mother, I'm her only child. She has no grandchildren.
Right.
But I felt, knowing how it was growing up without a father, and though my mother does a stellar job, mm-hmm, I knew something was missing.
Mm-hmm.
And that void couldn't be filled.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't want to have a child to have that same experience.
Sure.
And that was it was selfish.
And I mean,
I think I made the right choice.
But that's the choice
for
that
me.
You made it.
For me. But other people don't care. They just drop them and keep on going.
Well, here's my thing. Even if you are a single parent, doesn't Mother's Day and Father, doesn't it cover that? That's your day of being a mother. You're single, but that's your day of being a mother. So
I think it does.
It should. You don't need a single parent day. You don't need, then do we get a, we still together day? Do we get both of your parents in the house? Let's celebrate that. Hey, your parents are still here together. We get a day. When does it stop? It's a Mother's Day. It's a Father's Day. And that's enough. Everybody is covered under each umbrella. And let's just leave it as so. Because this is how we get confused on things. This is how things just team too much. Stay in your lane.
That's team too much.
This is team too much.
It is.
Stay in your lane. You don't need 2 days. You have Mother's Day. There's Father's Day. Let the fathers have their day.
And that's what I feel like they're taking away from dads.
They are taking away from dads.
I feel like you're cheapening the experience,
yes,
making it seem like they have no value,
yes,
because unfortunately a woman has to step up and do more than the person that she procreated with, whether it's an ex-husband or some man. But that's not fair because we don't take Mother's Day and we don't try to take over it for single dads. And I know several
I do too
single dads that are killing it.
I do too.
That are doing an exceptional job.
Yes. I do too. I think it's unfair. I will firmly stand on this is unfair, and it's just not right.
I'm gonna say, and Angel Soft got a lot of scrutiny
good.
And negative feedback on this.
Good.
And I think it should have, because my